Good morning, boys and girls. Praise the Lord. Today is 16th day of May 2021. And I'm so happy to be with you to come and study the Word of God together. My name is Pastor Jane. And we are going to do our Bible study today from my beautiful Bible. The Bible. And before we do that, I want us to pray. So, there is a lot of misfortune, and I want us to share the misfortune. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we want to thank you this morning. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for giving us a new day when we have come to learn your word. Help us, dear Lord, so that we can be able to understand what we are being taught. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Yes, boys and girls, I have told you, we are going to get our Bible story from my Bible in the book of 1 Kings, chapter number 15, and verse 9-4. And it is a very good story. Our topic is we need to remain strong, even when things seem to be so hard and difficult. Children, from that story, in the first thing of the scene, we are going to see or to learn about King Arthur. King Arthur. You see, children? He is King Arthur. And King Arthur, his mother was called Maka. And Maka was a daughter to Absalom. And Absalom was a son to King David. Again, that means King Arthur was a grandchild of King David. And I want to do something for you, because King Arthur loved God so much. And he wanted God to be like his grandfather. So in my picture here, I want you to look at it by the help of mommy and daddy at the home, and you see what is in my picture. I say that King Arthur was so loving. He loved God like his grandfather, King David. You see? Love, King Arthur loved God just like his grandfather, King David. And we get that from 1 Kings chapter 15 and verse 11. Yes, boys and girls. King Arthur, when he became a king, there before, all the other kings were bad. They bad kings. They did not worship the true God. And King Arthur was so sad. He felt so sad. He couldn't believe it. Why don't you worship the true God? The God who loves us all? You know what, boys and girls? God will always be with people. Sure, it is. When King Arthur felt so sad, he thought, no way. This cannot be like this. I have to be something. And because he loved God, he destroyed all the images, all the bad things, all the images that other people had made, like they were to worship God. And you know what, boys and girls? He destroyed all of them. And you see, it's only God, the true God, who is supposed to be worshipped. You see him here with his men destroying all the idols. And what is idol, boys and girls? Idols, they are those things that we love more than God. Anything that you keep on talking about more than God, that is an idol. And boys and girls, Arthur did all the good things. The things that were put and doubt, King Asa trusted God in everything he did. And when he was taking away all the idols that were made by other kings and they were not worshiping God, he trusted in God. You see, boys and girls, here we have King Asa, who trusted God very much, and God was with him. And because he trusted God, God gave him victory. So whatever he did, God was so happy with him, and he helped him. So boys and girls, what are we learning today? That we should not fear. We should remain strong. Because King Asa could have feared, oh, other kings were there. He did not destroy all those idols that other things are, that people were worshipping. Because they feared that people would hate him. They feared that people would leave him. But King Asa stood strong and said, I'll destroy everything that you people you are worshipping instead of the true God. And boys and girls, that is what King Asa did. And because he trusted God, God gave him victory. Boys and girls, today we know, or we are supposed to know, that the things that we do today, it is to begin to worship God. And not the children, we need to know that God choose people who will work for him, and he gives them strength. And they don't fear. Because them that trust in the Lord, God is always in the field. There is some difficult word that we have to know. Because we have to remain strong in the battle. Children, what is battle? Battle is when we engage in a fight. When we want to fight, or when people are fighting, that is battle. And also, we have to look at a hard word, that is rage. From our memory that we will get that hard word. And what is a rage? Rage is to run to and fro. Right? Boys and girls. And the other word that we are going to look at from the story that we have read from the book of 1 Kings, chapter 15, 9 to 24, is territory. What is that territory? A territory is an area that belongs to a nation. Like now, Kenya, that a territory. So no one, our president cannot allow somebody to go in. And the other did not allow any other person from outside to come and bring other gods, other idols to be worshipped other than the true God. And the other hard word is Jesus. When you read that chapter, you'll get a chapter, a hard word, the teaching. And what is teaching, boys and girls? Teaching is an argument. When Arthur destroyed the idol or took away the idol, see where what we saw, him destroying the idol, see, he consulted another king. And that king was Baasha. He consulted, he requested King Asa, as King Baasha, if they can fight the bad people who are worshiping other gods other than the true God. And so they made a treaty. They made an agreement to work together. Boys and girls, remember we said Asa was a grandson to King David. And King David trusted God and he obeyed God. And we have also seen that Asa followed his grandfather. So, if his grandfather was alive that day, oh, he could have been so happy and so proud because his grandson was obedient and trusted in God. Boys and girls, you are there. Can you do anything to make your grandpa, grandma, or mommy, daddy, or auntie to be happy? Just because you have obeyed, you may have done that. Obey and trust God. and God will be happy. Now we are going to do our memory verse. This will come from the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter number 16 and verse 9. This is the Bible. 2 Chronicles, chapter number 16 and verse 9. And there that our Bible tells us, it is saying that it is chapter 16, verse 9a. It is saying, for the eyes of the Lord rage throughout the earth to strengthen those whose hearts are fully committed to Him. I'll repeat it again. For the eyes of the Lord rage throughout the earth to strengthen those whose hearts are fully committed to Him. You know what boys and girls? God in heaven, His eyes are looking here on earth to see if there is anyone, you or me, who can be fully committed, who can fully give his life, his everything to serve God. Are you ready to serve God, boys and girls? Yes, we need to be present to God. And that brings us to the end of our Bible story today. So, boys and girls, remember that God will always give His people sure victory. Because when we give ourselves to God, any battle that we'll go to fight, the spiritual battle, then God will give us victory. So, boys and girls, be obedient. You can read the word of God and do what is right. And that brings us to the end of our Bible study today. May God bless all of us. May God be with you. Let us pray. Thank you, dear Jesus, for reminding us that in the battle that we are in, when we are small or old, you will be with us. We pray that, Lord, you help us to trust in you so that we can have victory in everything that we do. Help us to do the good thing, the things that pleases you, just like King Arthur did, because you have promised us to be with us. We thank you and we bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we